An historic day in Cuba, and WPBF 25 News is the only local news team here in Havana as the highest-ranking diplomats from the U.S. to come to Cuba in almost 40 years sit down to talk with Cuban officials about doing away with decades of economic sanctions. Good evening. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny, live in the WPBF News studios. Thank you for joining us for WPBF 25 News at 5. Todd?
Well, Tiffany, I can tell you already, it has been quite a day. We got up early this morning and went down to Miami. 42 minutes in the air to fly from Miami to Havana and went back, as you might imagine, several decades, maybe almost much as half a century in what we saw. Yet even though it isn't easy to get to Havana, we found out a lot of people in South Florida have been doing it for some time to see family. Take a look at what we found at the airport. We originally expected to see a few people on perhaps a small charter plane getting on board to go to Havana. Instead, we were met by about 150, mostly Cuban Americans, heading back to Cuba to visit their families. And they were dwarfed by the various mounds of luggage they had. We're talking big screen TVs, household goods, clothing, all in an effort to make life better for the people back home. We even were lucky enough to meet a famous Cuban music star, who you'll hear more about coming up in a later broadcast. When we touched down at Jose Marti Airport today, it was old, it was small, but what we'll remember are the faces of the people at the airport, the joy all these families had to see their people coming home, at least for a visit. Now, we actually drove the streets of Havana. The old American cars that you would expect were there, but there's much more. There's much more to talk about in terms of technology, the gaps in technology here, the people of Cuba, how they received us. I can tell you it is a friendly place. It's a place I'm hoping to explore so much more. Now, we mentioned the diplomatic talks. Those talks began today, but tomorrow the key talks begin between the Assistant Secretary of State and the Cuban government to talk so much about opening shipping to Cuba, more American companies investing in Cuba, and giving Cuban citizens closer access to U.S. diplomats to show them what American life is really like. We'll talk much more about this coming up at 5:30, but for now, I'm Todd McDermott live in Havana, Cuba. Never thought I'd ever say that. Back to Tiffany and Aaron in the studio.
Yeah, it's something you don't hear very often, Todd. Well, I got to ask you, what was your initial reaction to your surroundings as you stepped off the plane, you got out of customs, and you made your way into town? What's your takeaway from that drive into the heart of the city?
Well, the takeaway looked like a lot of tropical countries you might have been to or seen, except that some of the infrastructure, as you might imagine, is severely damaged. We are in old Havana. We have already set up our place in Havana now. It looks a lot like a European city, like a city you might see in Italy or a city in Spain, but at the same time, it has deteriorated far more than you would see in many cities. And as a Cuban American told me today at the airport, that's because there haven't been American dollars spent here, and they need those American dollars, whether or not the government changes here. But Tiffany, I have so much more to tell you. There's so much more to talk about here. It's been a long day just to get here, get through customs, get our permits to report for you, but we have a lot more to talk about, including the Michael Jackson of Cuba, who we met today in the Miami airport, and we talked to for a long time here at Jose Marti Airport. I'm excited to bring the story to you, history being made, but also a look at Cuba that I think most of us have never seen.
You know, Todd, you mentioned getting through customs, and I know you're going to talk about that a little later, but just quickly, what was that process like once you landed and getting through? Because that's a short flight, but I think the process of getting into the city probably took you longer.
This might surprise you, though. It wasn't so much getting through customs. It wasn't getting our passports stamped. It wasn't checking our visas. It was just getting the bags off the plane. That took longer than the flight, in fact, much longer. But the memory I'm always going to have of arriving in Havana, Cuba, is walking out those airport doors into this sea of smiling faces, people cheering, waving signs, waiting for their loved ones to arrive. It's really like nothing I've ever seen at any airport I've ever been to. It was pretty overwhelming, and I'll always remember it.
All right, Todd, we can't wait to talk with you more about your experiences. We'll check back in with you throughout the show. Todd McDermott, live from Havana, Cuba tonight.